Welcome to MCN. We're in Australia, in Sydney, and we're about to ride Yamaha's new XJ6 Diversion and XJ6 Naked. We're going to do a very quick video review and tell you what the bike's like. Naked version. It's just called the XJ6, and without its fairing, it actually looks more like a mini street fighter than the fared version, which looks more sort of a comfortable commuter. This bike's about $4,500. It's January 09 now, so the price is set about that. The ABS is about £150-200 more expensive, and the XJ6 Diversion is about £4,900, and it's 5.2 with the ABS. Now, both of these bikes are aimed at the new rider, and the rivals are going to be things like the Suzuki GSX 650, the Suzuki Bandit, Honda CBF 600, and the Kawasaki ER6F. You could also throw the Aprilia Shiver or Ducati Monster in there, but this naked version looks really good fun, and we're going to find out what it's like to ride very shortly. Okay, to give this bike its full name, it's the Yamaha XJ6 Diversion, and it's got the half fairing and belly pan. It's completely new steel chassis and a revised version of the Yamaha FZ6 engine. The FZ6 engine is slightly more powerful, which in turn is based on an older R6 motor. This engine has been retuned for more mid-range power, and lots of ancillaries on it have all been kind of softened off and made really user-friendly. One of the nicest touches on this bike is the under-slung exhaust, rather, which they say lowers the center of gravity and improves the mid-range. The chassis isn't quite as stiff as the Phaser, so it's a little bit more forgiving. The seat's nice and low, the tank's nice and narrow. The rear tyre is a 160 instead of a 180 section to make the bike more nimble and more agile around town. Here at a bit of a coffee break mid-morning. I've just ridden this Diversion through the streets of Sydney and out on the twisty roads. First impressions is that it is very easy to ride, very light, very nimble, basically everything Yamaha said it would be. It's a nice little commuting tool, be a nice first bike, low seat. The only couple of things about it, the fuel injection around town at very low speed when you're easing off is a bit lurchy, and the engine is a little bit buzzy. Even though it's only spinning at 3,000 or 4,000 revs, it sounds a bit busy, and I guess that's because it's based on the R6 engine. Not as relaxed as you'd imagine it to be for this sort of bike. Right, we've been riding a bit further, and we've just made another stop at a place called Wiseman's Ferry, which is north of Sydney, and I've just been riding this XJ6. Now, fundamentally it's the same bike as a Diversion, but without a fairing. It's a tiny little bit lighter, but the engine's the same, the suspension is the same, but it's got a completely different character. It feels a lot lighter and a lot like a mini stunt bike, whereas the Diversion feels like more of a sensible commuter. Although, having said that, it's not as shall we say sensible as a CBF 600. The Diversion still has a lot of power, and enough to make you smile when you want to. So it is a good commuter and good fun as well. But the XJ6 really is a fun little motorbike. The throttle actually feels a little bit smoother on this. So I'm going to ride a few of the other bikes to see if the jerkiness on the Diversion I was riding this morning was just a one-off. that's the end of our day on the XJ6 Diversion and the XJ6. Both bikes are very good. They both do what they set out to do. They're very easy to ride. They're good fun, very simple, very easy to get on with machines. Not really any downsides. The motor's a little bit buzzy. It would be nice if it had a little bit more torque. It does feel quite busy when you're riding it, but it's something you soon get used to. And the fueling on some of the bikes isn't so good at low speed, but on some of them it's fine. So maybe there's just a couple of kind of less than perfect bikes there, but even the bad ones are still pretty good around town. Slight lurching off the throttle. The pick of the bunch really is the XJ6. Without the fairing, it's just a little hooligan. Really, really good fun to ride. Feels much more taut, much better handling, much lighter, but it's the same bike as the one with the fairing. And if anyone's ever ridden a sports bike with the fairing taken off, you'll know that it just sort of transformed it into an animal. But overall, both bikes are very good and should give the competition a good run for their money. See you soon.